everybody knows what that is, but it's a pan of hot water. And did everybody manage to get a jar to use for the liquid?
How big should it be?
It doesn't need to be very big at all. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. The problem, you won't be able to reuse it or unfortunately recycle it either. It once the pine resin's in there, it's impossible to clean out. So it'll have to be something that's going to get ditched. So I went ahead and melted mine, but start yours. I had to make a big batch, so it takes a while to melt. And I just have it on a medium heat on my stove.
So what are you putting together?
So in your kit, you have three things. One is the beeswax. Where am I? There. The beeswax pellets. Oh, and you want a quarter cup of that. I think I have extra beeswax for everybody. Okay. Is that what came in volumes? You want to pour that in your jar, and then it's an amount of the pine rosin. Pour the whole thing in. That's actually already measured for you, because it's really messy to measure. And the same with the jojoba oil. So you want all of those.
This is the pine rosin, the flowery stuff.
Yeah. And try not to get on your counter. This is one you might want to actually lay down newspaper, because it's very dusty, and it took literally 4 weeks to finally wear off my counter. So.
And so how much of the beeswax do we put in?
Beeswax would be 1/4 cup.
Okay.
Yeah. That's that way. Make sure that's right. 1/4 cup beeswax, and then your pine resin should be exactly 3 tablespoons. And then the jojoba oil is 1 tablespoon. So if you end up doing a lot of these later, like for Christmas, while you guys are doing that, the pine resin comes in packets like this. And it's usually really chunky, and you have to break it up. I put it in another bag and I hammer it until it finally becomes powder. Or at least really small chunks, because it takes a long time to melt. Has everybody got that going?
So we put this, we stir it up, and then we put it in the boiling water, right?
And then that's going to take maybe, it's up to 20 minutes to really melt. The pine resin takes the longest, so. And then turn your oven on to 300.
300.
So now, while that's all going, the first thing we'll do is take your fabric. And we have two different kinds of fabric, two different patterns out there. And you'll see, this was the hardest math problem I've had in the century, taking all the fabric and dividing it up into the right sizes. So I have extra fabric here, and you should probably have enough resin after we're done to make some more of these. So what I want to do, there's several sizes that work really well. I've actually found the smaller sizes to be a little bit more usable.
Yeah. So is 100% cotton the best fabric to use, or does it matter?
Cotton, because it's going to have to absorb some of the wax, so it's more absorbent than everything. And I wash it first, because almost always fabric has sizing.
Yeah. Okay, good.
And before I start, this one is somebody I bought, or somebody gave this to me for Christmas. This was from the Wildflower Center, and it's beeswax wrap, and they actually put a button on the side with a string, and you can wrap it in any way you want. But I'm gonna show you this, 1 second. I really like these a lot, and I end up using them a lot of times around fruit. Something like that, and it sticks really well. And when you first use them, it's gonna feel a little bit too sticky, but it kind of gets better with age.
You mean, meaning after you wash it and clean it after the first couple of times, or?
Just I think, the wax is hard. The jojoba oil and the pine resin keep it a little bit tacky and not quite. stiff, sorry, stiff. And just kind of break, I think the more you use it, it kind of breaks down the wax a little bit. And when you wash them, by the way, you can only use just like cold soapy water. So, okay, so does everybody have a big square, at least one? I'm trying to remember, I did these a long time ago. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna cut this into a 12 by 12. Or cut it in half, 21, 21. That's another thing you can do is just cut it in half. That might be the best. Depending on what size. I think I gave everybody the same size, but I'm not completely sure. So we're gonna cut this in half. And then eventually, if you make more things, you'll figure out what size you'd like the best.
21, 14 and a half.
Yeah. And I'm probably going to cut the selvage off. I have a selvage here with words on it. I don't want that. The size doesn't matter a whole lot. So, and what we're going to do too, I don't actually have never owned pinking shears. So you can do this with pinking shears, but don't worry about it right now. I have found that it's much better to trim after they're made. It's much easier. Okay. So does everybody have about two large squares and three small ones now?
No.
No, what do you have?
I haven't started cutting.
Oh.
I'm measuring. Yeah, you've got a mathematician here.
Yeah, I've got to do this.
All right. Yeah, sorry.
No, it's fine. No, it's hard to know. You gotta go. Sometimes you have to go find your scissors and you have to take a long time.
Ten and a half.
Hi, Maria.
Hi.
Good to gather with you. And Beth. Hi, Beth. And I saw B already. Yeah, good.
I determined that I had to just watch you today and write me down notes. I'm not capable of doing this at the same time.
Well, yeah, that's fine. And you know, the Zoom is on the library's website, too.
I'm also just watching and taking notes today. So you know, that works out best for me.
With all the stress of the election, if anybody would show up, everyone would show up. You know, it's hard to know. All right, so first let's put, are you finished? Anya, are you finished cutting?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I'm finished.
Sheila, are you finished cutting too?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's start with a small one. And what I'm gonna do is, you can do this many ways. I have a cookie sheet with parchment paper on it, and that seems to work really well. So if you wanna get that out, wait a minute until you can get that out.
How about, instead of parchment, how about, you said tin foil?
Tin foil is fine.
Okay, got it.
I think even newspaper would work if you could get it flat.
7 by 9.
Mostly you'll get a little bit of residue coming off of these. So you don't want it to stick to your tray. It's really hard to clean off stuff. I learned the hard way.
Six. Mute me, please.
Has anybody's stuff melted yet?
Nope, not mine. Do we stir it? Should we stir?
You should have a brush in your kit.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, use that brush because you'll never get it off of utensils. So.
Okay.
Mostly didn't take a whole lot of stirring. It will just start melting by itself at some point. So while this is happening, I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate because it may take a little bit for this to melt.
Yeah.
Okay. So here's what I'm going to do. Let's see. I'm going to just move this over for a minute. Okay. So I have my thingy here, my cloth, and I'll dip it in and I will paint on here. And this feels really awkward at first because it doesn't saturate that well. And you don't want to cover every square inch, because what we're going to do in a minute is we're going to put it in the oven. And the little blobs that are left, the little ridges of wax, will just smooth right out. So my first mistakes were to put too much on. So you don't really put very much on at all. Don't even worry about the edges, because that's kind of it. Now, I don't know if you can, you probably can't see this either, but no, you can't tell anything. Okay. It's got little ridges of wax on it, but it's just kind of brushed on loosely.
Just one side.
Just one side, and it's going to melt through. And after we melt it, we'll check it in a minute. So what I'm going to do now is I'm putting this in the oven for about 3 minutes. And that'll melt it. And if you leave it much longer, like 10 minutes, it'll start smoking. And don't ask me how I know that. But if you want to do a bunch of them, it's probably better to put it in your oven like at 250. Or 225 even. It just needs to be a beeswax melt at a really low temperature. So that way you don't have to worry so much. And while that's happening, I learned some interesting thing about the tree resin that we used, which tree resin is harvested, and trees make it. It's harvested either by wounding the tree, which is the old fashioned way, and it kind of bleeds, and this is what it bleeds. And there's newer ways where you harvest much more sustainably, and it's kind of a dripping system. So if you do go buy this on the internet, there's one site on Amazon in particular that says we harvest the sustainable way. But pine resin is used by the tree. It's antiseptic. And when a tree gets a wound, there's all these cells lining through the whole tree, and it gets wounded. It's a little like a pop blister, and the resin pops out. And it's antiseptic, so it doesn't get infections. And immediately insects like to go into the tree wound, and this will trap them. So it works for that way too. And there's another version that you all know really well. Pine resin is a thicker, denser one, and it's usually from pine trees, coniferous trees. But the other lighter thing is sap, and sap is the same thing. So maple syrup is sap. It's just a much lighter, thinner version from a different tree.
So is that what happens is amber? Like it's the sap, and then
exactly
go in there, and
so it's pretty cool stuff. And you can also make salve that the people swear by. You take tree resin, you mix like a jojoba oil, and you can rub it on your wounds, and it I want to try it. People think it's really like it. All right, I'm gonna get this out of the oven in about 3 minutes. All right, now the next thing I'm gonna do is, in there, in the direction I said, get a pot scrubber or a piece of wood or something like that. That seems to work best. And I'm gonna hold this because it's hot, and I'm just gonna scrape hard. And in a minute, you don't have to use the hot pad, but you can see, can you tell the little pots, the little bits of resin coming off, the shiny? So I'm taking off excess, and I'm also spreading, like I can see in my, you probably can't see this in your light, I can see little dry pockets. And it's good, I didn't put too much on this time. Sometimes I have globs coming over, and I'm gonna turn it over. And now I can see there's some dry spots right there that I don't really have enough to smear into. So at this point, I'm gonna put just a little bit more in the dry spots. There's some at that edge too. And then if it's still hot enough, I can just brush it. If it cools down, you just stick it right back in the oven. It's actually a really easy process.
Is that going to mess up that pot, the thing that you have in your left hand, the green thing?
Yeah, totally.
Oh, okay.
My husband's used to, the Tupperware is usually gone for some art project. This will now be this, yeah.
What should we use for that? Just anything that will be thrown away?
Yeah, you can even use a piece of an edge of hard cardboard would work too. Just something that you can scrape a little bit with. Wait, so yeah.
I'm talking not with the right hand. I'm talking about that green, dark green thing that you holding it down.
It's a pot holder that I don't care about.
Okay, got it.
Yeah. And for some reason, it's not, the wax is not sticking to that very well. So yeah, I find these really irritating. I'm old fashioned, like the cloth ones. All right, so at this point, I'm done. And then it cools off so fast that directions always say to put it on a hanger like this to cool down. And then just hang it up somewhere to cool. But I have found they cool so fast that I'll just lay it out on, you know, a piece of newspaper or something like that. And then that works fine too.
So is our stuff supposed to be, mine's still not melted at all. It's been a double boiler now for what, 10 minutes?
All. Is anybody else's not melted at all? Maria, how's yours? Hey, how are you? Hi, Lydia. It's not melted. Is it melted? I can't tell.
It's melted. Lydia's been working it.
Yeah, okay. So Anya, just I guess be patient until it melts. Turn your double boiler up a little bit.
Okay. Actually, it was on high for a while.
So yeah. Should we do like two at a time on the cookie sheet or?
Yeah. And your only limitation is the size of your tray. And in fact, I was doing some volume ones earlier and I have two trays, two cookie sheets. And I was just going back and forth and back and forth. So yeah, there's no limit. And one thing that's a good trick to do is when you start painting, instead of picking this up to turn or turning over, I just turn this parchment paper around if you need to turn it while you do it. Okay, so I'm gonna do another one and you guys can do it with me or watch again or. This one's easier to see that I can see the wax going on. Every now and then you can find a fabric that has bees on it, but it goes really fast.
So can you put the mixture in the microwave and would it do better that way? This is just still hard as anything.
Yeah, try it just watch it really carefully. Yeah, try it and see. You know, I melt chocolate that on in the microwave too. You just have to sit with it. You just don't want to overcook it. All right, so I have one more done and I can stick another small one on there. So I hope you guys appreciate the color patterns because that took me a very long time to pick the fabric out. Way longer than it should have. I love the smell of this. Oh my God, it smells so good. Pine tree. Like I think I'm gonna give these for Christmas presents this year. They're so expensive to buy in the store.
Yes, I already bought some about a year ago. Love it.
Crazy expensive.
So tell me how different ways that you actually use it. You wrap like fruit and vegetables that are cut up in it?
Yeah, and let me see what I have right now. I even have, let's see. Loosely, I don't have a top for this pitcher and I've been making cold brew and this is the first thing. I just folded it over and grabbed it and stuck it on. So,
and it holds itself on kind of.
Pretty well, yeah. It makes a pretty good, it's kind of impressive. Yeah. So almost anything that you would use like foil for, if anybody uses foil anymore, and then, you know, plastic bags too, which I really try and get away from. So if I can. So like that.
How do you know when to take it out?
Huh?
How do you know when to take it out of the oven?
About 3 to 5 minutes.
And if you weren't timing it?
I wasn't, but I did the first time I started doing it, I tied 3 minutes. And also I have a little clock up here I can see.
I mean, what does it look like? Like if I were to look at it in the oven.
Yeah, I don't know if you can, okay, you can't see this. There's, when I pasted this on, when it's in its raw state, there's little ridges of wax on it. When you take it out of the oven, it's all, the ridges are all gone. They've all just melted. So if you just give it three minutes, and that will be for sure will do it. It kind of loses its shine in the oven because it's warm and hot. Another one. Anybody got one done yet?
No, I'm still warming up the.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I had that happen one day. I don't know if it was too colder outside or what, but it took a long time for it to heat. And the next day,
I put it in the microwave now 5 times, you know.
It's still not doing it.
Not yet, but we'll see.
Well, it might be your evening project. Your after dinner project.
Yeah.
All right, so I'll do this one now too. Yeah, the other difficult thing about this project is like the pine resin and the beeswax, you pretty much have to buy volume. So it gets kind of expensive. So it's good that the library got us these supplies and I can divide them up.
So if we decide these would be nice little Christmas gifts, is there a place to source these things?
I just had to do Amazon.
Amazon?
Yeah, and I'll give you my, is there a way to get my email to them? A chat box or something, Gloria?
Sure, I'll add it to the chat.
Okay. So then you can just, I can send you the links if you want without having to do all the research of which ones are sustainable and all that. That took a while.
Okay, that'd be great.
And you know, in Austin, there's just not many fabric stores left. That's the other issue.
Yeah.
And I don't really like any of them, but that's too bad.
There's that beehive on it, Bee Cave Road across with the Cracker Dog, and there's that place right there where the Cracker Dog is, and there's a upholstery repair shop that has, I think it's called the Beehive or something. It's a crafting studio, but she's got fabric.
What location? What area of town?
No, it's on Bee Cave Road, right by the Cracker Dog. When you're going into town from the library, from Laura's, it's on your right hand side. There's
a Shell station.
Yeah, I was trying to think which side of the Shell station it was on. I think it's on the far side.
Where the vet is too?
Huh?
Is it where the veterinarian is also?
It's not in the same place as the veterinarian and the Shell station. It's a little bit further down, I think.
Okay. Further in closer to town.
Yeah, thank you. Yes.
And what's it called?
I think it's the Beehive, but she sells fabric and it is cute. I mean, I have not been there. It's also a crafting studio, which I don't think she's been doing because of COVID. But
that is really good to know.
You know, what is so fun about that is Doris Walcott, who started the West Bank Libraries, before she did the library, she had a fabric store called the Beehive on Bee Cave Road.
Is that right?
But it's not the same one.
I used to spend hours at London Fabrics, for those of you who are around long enough to know London Fabrics.
Yeah, right.
So this last one, The second one cooled off before I got to it, so I'm going to put them both back in the oven. Yeah, I tried to order fabric online, but you know, it's just so hard to do without touching it, feeling it, and smelling it. It's complicated. Oh. All right, so while you're working on that, I'm gonna go. My apron keeps getting caught. I'm gonna show you while you guys are working. This is the one that we just made. And you can see it's got little hairs on it sticking out from being trimmed. So all I'm gonna do is trim it right now. And it's the easiest thing in the world. So you don't have to worry about doing it ahead of time. And I also tried to get fabric for you guys that has, it's so easy to cut if it's got a pattern that you can follow the markings to see if you've got a straight line. This is also good to trim because sometimes the very edges don't get enough wax. And I didn't catch that, so.
So the edges are sealed now though, once it's been.
In fact, yeah. This is the way they used to make wax picnic tablecloths before vinyl was invented. And there's some gorgeous wax cloth projects too. And then there you have it. Kind of straight. I might straighten that a little bit. One edge. Yay! So how'd everybody do with daylight savings time?
Okay.
Good?
Is that it?
Yeah.
I woke up at 4:30 one morning. Does anybody have any questions?
Did you, when you turned it over to check it, was it, had you already put it in the oven at that point?
Yeah, and then you can see where it didn't saturate through, and then when I turn it over, I'll put a little bit more in the back.
And then did you put it back in the oven?
It depends on if it's cooled off. If it's really still hot enough, no, but most of the time I have to put it back in the oven because it cools off so fast. And also, I'm using this hot pad as you see, but really within about 30 seconds, I can actually just use my fingers. It just shouldn't stay very hot. And that makes it a little easier.
I'm finding it's beginning to stick to the tin foil, which is sort of weird on the other side.
You know, really, I haven't, you know what? I've only read about using tin foil. If it's too much of a problem, try newspaper. That would probably work. As long as it doesn't get the ink on it come up. I don't think it will, but. Because you end up using less wax, I think, as you go further. One more to take it. That one's
Barbara, I have a question.
Yeah.
Carol, so how do I know if
I took it out after 3 minutes and I used a board to smooth it out. It's pretty sticky. I have it on a hanger. Is it ready or do I need to stick it back in the oven?
Does it feel pretty smooth?
It does feel smooth, but you know, yeah. I have wax on my hands now.
Yeah, it's probably totally fine. In fact, the first time I did this, I was thinking, these are too sticky. Once you get the wax off your hands, they do still feel a little sticky for the first 3 or 4 uses. And then I don't know what happens, but it settles down.
Okay.
Yeah. So as long as you've got relatively smooth and not the ridges of the wax, you're exactly right. It will feel that way.
Okay. Perfect. Yeah. Do the other ones. Thank you.
Yeah.
Hey, Barbara, it's Sheila. Can you remind me again, how do you clean these between uses? I think you might have talked about that, but I wasn't paying attention.
Remind you what?
How do you clean between uses? I think you might have told us, but I wasn't paying attention.
I never figured a way to clean. So, you know, it's basically, resins are basically solvent-based in a way. So, you know, if you really were stuck, you could probably use a turpentine or something, but I just kept cleaning with soap and water and it came off after a while.
I meant the fabrics between uses. Do you clean
just cold water and soap. Oh. And it's basically inherently, it's like a cutting board. Cutting boards are inherently antiseptic. The wood, the resin and the wood are antiseptic. It's the same kind of thing. It doesn't take a ton of cleaning. Oh. One I've used for 3 months. And I just rinse it off with a little soap and I can tell by the smell. I've never smelled bad.
Hey, Barbara, how often do you need to reapply the wax on it, like after some use? Do you do it once every 3 months, or it just depends?
I haven't ever had to reapply it so far.
How long have you used this?
It's only been 3 or 4 months since I've used them. But however, okay. I'll change my mind on that. This one I've had for 2 years, the one that was store-bought,
mm-hmm.
I've never had to do anything to it. It ends up getting kind of crinkly looking, like wax paper or something, but I've never had to add anything to it. So I think you won't have to.
Okay, great.
Yeah. And you've also got, I think, the beeswax, which is another amazing product.
Mm-hmm.
Also helps it just keep be permanent. It's also antiseptic. We just discovered this afternoon a new beehive in our yard in an old tree. We have one that's in another tree. We had two and one of the trees fell down. And it was really sad because we plant all our yard just for the bees and the butterflies. And then we took down a branch last 8 months ago. So there's a hole in this walnut tree and I just saw it. It's now a bee's nest. I'm really excited. All right, so I guess that's about it. Has anybody got theirs finished? Got at least one or two finished? Let me go back to my gallery view. Let's see. Oh yeah, hi Sheila. Yeah. Perfect. Yay. And Bee, that looks good. Of course, Bee has a beautiful watercolor behind her. Beatrice is a watercolor artist.
What's your favorite size?
The smaller ones I end up using more.
So I was looking online. They were showing pictures of sandwiches being wrapped in this.
Yeah.
And then one of the pictures had where it would stick around the edge of your storage bowl.
Uh-huh.
So a circle might be nice.
That's a great idea. I hadn't even thought about that. Yep. Especially if you've got round bowls. Yeah.
Yeah.
But Lydia, you got one? Not yet. Where's Ella?
Ella's supposed to be at their virtual acting camp, but I don't know what happened.
Well, I guess we will end the session, and you guys, again, you will have taken over the kitchen, and you'll have to remember at some point you'll have to cook dinner, right? Hey, look at Anya. Looks good.
And so I can say that...